Devastated families in Thailand gather for the cremation of the victims in last week's mass shooting at a daycare center. The massacre claimed 36 lives, including those of 24 children. Thailand's prime minister and two deputy ministers attended the ceremonies held at different temples. The kingdom has been stunned by the tragedy in northeastern Nak Lang province, one of the worst mass killings in its history. The funeral, sponsored by the royal household, and 3 days of rites that began Saturday. The death toll from the landslide in Venezuela rises to 43. Hundreds of rescue personnel continue to comb through the mud and debris in search of the 56 people who remain missing. The landslide hit Las Tejeras town over the weekend after torrential rains triggered floods. Officials say over 1,000 homes were either partially damaged or completely destroyed. The National Telecommunications Commission has its work cut out as it formulates the implementing rules and regulations for the SIM registration law. As Warren de Guzman tells us, while there is strong support for the measure to help fight cybercrime, there are also a lot of concerns on how it will be carried out.
The National Telecommunications Commission has 60 days from the effectivity of the Mandatory SIM Registration Act to formulate the implementing rules and regulations of the measure signed into law by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Monday. The act itself already has provisions on how the registration should be done, but the IRR will spell everything out so all stakeholders are on the same page. Former NTC Deputy Commissioner and current NTC Consultant Edgardo Cabarrios vows they will address all of the concerns surrounding the measure.
Ito po ay makakatulong ng malaki, ano? Kasi magdadalawang isip po yung gumawa ng masama kasi ma-identify sila. Yun hong data supplied by yung registrant, no, yung owner ng SIM ay absolutely confidential. Nakalagay po sa batas. So, lahat ng data na yan i-transfer sa isang central database which is government, say NPC or NPC, etc.
The concerns are real. Take student Chloe Jane. She does not agree with the SIM Registration Act, but she says she will register to avoid the hassle of having her SIM deactivated.
Para po sa akin, parang malalaman na po agad yung information ko. Wala na pong privacy. Baka siguro po doon na po malalaman yung makukuha yung information para sa mga scam po, ng mga scammers.
Based on NTC data, there are over 160 million active SIMs in the Philippines and 152 million of them are prepaid. Postpaid SIMs are already registered, so telecoms companies can simply turn over that data. Former Information and Communications Technology Secretary Eliseo Rio says based on how telcos have been able to protect the personal data of postpaid SIM registrants, prepaid SIM registration should not be a problem.
Kailangan may postal address so that the bills will go to these addresses, no? Wala naman issue na so-called identity theft and things like that. The telcos have, the necessary tools to address this problem.
Many tech experts stress SIM registration is not a silver bullet and incidents of smishing and other text-based scams are likely to persist.
Makakatulong itong mabawasan yung mga spam. Ang nangyayari kasi ngayon, pag tin-raise mo, kung sinong nang scam sa'yo, dead end. Wala ka na kasi 25 lang, makakabili ka na ng SIM card, tatapon mo lang yun, wala na. Wala na, hindi mo na matitrace.
Stopgap lang naman talaga ito sa mga current volume of attempts ng pag-scam, pag-spam sa atin. So, kung makontrol mo yung number of people using SIM cards, mas mapapaliit mo yung total chances na magamit ito sa kasamaan, di ba? Sa mga malisyosong paraan.
Another important point, not all cybercrimes utilize SIMs. Cybersecurity company Kaspersky notes the number of phishing attacks, which use emails instead of texts, hit over 1.8 million in the Philippines in just the first 6 months of this year. That is already higher than the over 1.3 million total for the whole of 2021. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.